Hi Jules, welcome back. Today we're going to be playing with some alcohol inks and some ceramic tiles. So we're going to make something very, very similar to this. I've been playing. So we are going to be playing with our ceramic tile and our alcohol inks and a little bit of alcohol. And we are going to see what we can make with these. See what color pretties that we can dip into. Alright, so let's move this out of the way. Alright, so I have another sitting here. We're gonna play. I've got another something or other I want to do, but I don't know how well it's gonna turn out. So, alright, so you're gonna need some alcohol inks. These are the Bria Reese alcohol inks. I've got several different colors to play with, so we are going to play. So, what you're going to do first is you are going to put a small, very light layer of alcohol onto your ceramic tile. And just kind of brush it on. Alright, so now we're going to start dropping some ink on this. So, we're going to start off with some blue. Look how pretty that is. Just a drop of ink to sit in the center. I'm slightly blowing on the ceramic tile. Don't tip it when you've got some dark inks. So that is what we have created with just a ceramic tile and our alcohol inks. Now, I'm going to try this with the heat gun and see what happens. There you have it. You took on maybe a little bit dark. There you go. Color the alcohol ink. So we now have two. So I'm going to go find something else to play with. I think I have just the thing. I'm going to play with some photo paper. And we will see. This does how it reacts. the glossy photo paper. What I'm going to do is we're just going to drop some alcohol on here. See what that does. And I still have paint on my brush. And we'll see what this does. See what happens. Did we get the reaction that we want? What you so desired? Let's try this and see what happens. Let's see if we have a blend in the colors. So this is the result from alcohol inks on photo paper. I don't think the colors are very vibrant from my computer, but that's okay. Y'all get that. Y'all get the drift, right? Yeah. And we have another piece of paper that we can play on. I've used this ever before. But I have read about it. I've seen other people use it. So we'll try it. This is Yupo paper. And so we are going to play with this. Let's see if I've got something in here. Ditched my scroll. I have some art straws. Yeah. Oh, there it is. Still in the package. Huh. So, what we are going to do is we are going to play. Wow, that's all bent up. Let's hope it works. Cross our fingers, guys. So what we're going to do is we are going to drop on some of this ink and see what happens when we try and put some air to it. Well, hot air. From the mouth. May not be the best creation if I'm limited on my colors, but you know, doing what I can with what I got. This brown, hopefully it'll work out. If don't, I need to die cut it and make it into something else, right? Yeah, I think so. Supposed to drop there, but that's okay. That is okay. Alright, let's see what this does. Here we go. Kind of darkened up on me. Too much dark colors. Too many dark colors. So, let's see what I can do. Let's drop some alcohol in here so we can break up some of that. Yeah. Let's see what happens. I think that happened on this one. But that is okay. We got something. Well, probably not to the desired color, but we did get something. And that just darkened up that orange. Yeah, not to our desired effect. A little bit too dark. Well, this is U-Bow paper. Never used it a day in my life, and I was just testing it out, so I don't know if it worked out for myself or not. Y'all tell me if that's what it's supposed to do. It's very shiny, but it's still wet in areas. So, if y'all have any pointers, make sure you tell me in the comments. Please, no rude comments. Please, no rude comments. Alright. What else do we have to play with? Let's see. And my watercolor paper is buried. Let's see what kind of pages we get. What is around me? like a shiny, shiny paper. I'm not sure exactly what it is. It's not exactly cardstock, but it's not. I don't know what it is. But we're gonna play with it. Let's play. All right. So let's see. Let's drop some alcohol on, see what happens. Spread it out a little bit. See what we get. No dark colors in blue. Almost like a cobalt blue, but this is called lake blue. Got a little bit of green. Straw trickle work on this. See if it will. Not much, because the alcohol seems to want to soak in really fast on the paper. I'm guessing you have to work very quickly in order to get leeway in this. We're just playing with some inks. Nothing serious. Don't get much of a turnout. Still want to try anyway. What's the harm in experimenting? You don't get much, but I reckon you can cut this into small pieces and put it in your die coat and make something totally different. Used to having these regular inks. I'm used to making my own alcohol inks in a spray bottle. I'm not used to this. But what's in the fun? We're playing. We're playing, right? Shoot, you can make some circus dots with that. You never know. Make some flowers, die cut them around the area there. You never know what you could do. Let's see. See if I can brush this. Brush. Yeah, you can brush it. Move around that color. Don't mix it too much, because you'll get mud like I'm doing. Very light. Some area. I think that's actually coming off. Use that ink to kind of brush it. In other words, you can paint with alcohol ink, but you gotta move quickly. I have some alcohol rather close. stain your hands, I would suggest getting some gloves because this is not a clean craft. These inks will stain, so. Well, there you go. Got some ink drops on some unknown paper. Not exactly sure. You even got another side to it. Look at that. Pretty. You can use either side. So you got three different crafts here. You got one using an unidentified paper. You've got one using photo paper. You've got one using UFO paper. And you have your ceramic tile. All you have to do to use these is to seal these with a sealer. And then boom, you've got your real pretty table piece or a something to put your coffee cups or your decorative pieces on here if you would like. So, yeah, seal them and display your beautiful arts. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming and visiting me today. Hopefully I inspired you to get out there and play with some of your inks and share your artwork. So, if you are not a part of our group, please come and join us on Facebook at Creative Jewels by Emily and share your artwork. Send a free request and get in there. I'm pretty sure that you're going to be loved. So, anyway, I'm going to go ahead and let you go. I'm going to give you a little bit of food for thought. So, it says, psychology fact. You are more than likely to achieve your goals if you keep them to yourself. What? I don't know about that. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I love you all. Thank you for coming in, and I will see you guys on my next video. Bye.